and he was the closest man to that ball. Actually, he was the closest longhorn to the ball. Justin Straichner almost came up with the interception. There was some confusion there. And that's going to bring up third and four. Big break for Gordon. That ball was a pick off. Third and four. Costilla has Tom Arena and Sizemore, and there's a little oopsie-doo around the right side to Tom Arena, and it doesn't do a thing. A little bit of a delayed handoff, the fake inside to Sizemore, and Tom Arena around on a delayed handoff coming around the near side, and he lost three. And this is a difficult decision. I think the Longhorns are going to go for it on fourth and now it's about the seventh. Fourth and seven for Morton. And now Sizemore goes back into punt formation. They need to punt here. They need to punt. Sizemore takes the snap. Gets off an end-over-end kick into the wind. That'll be a good one for Gordon. And it's going to go down inside the six-yard line. It's taken there by number nine, Joe Costilla, at the five-yard line. So Gordon accomplishes what they need to there to put Whitmerrill deep in their own territory, but the Longhorns is yet to be able to stop Whitmerrill.
They really haven't. You know, Whitmerrill has so many different weapons, but Brandon Rogers, I hate to keep hopping on this one guy, but he really is electrifying out there. He makes the play. You know, I don't know if you have to double the guy. You know, how can you double a guy? I mean, that takes a while to pass your team right there.
You don't, unless you want to take a great risk. Here we go. There's Lopez. Hands it off the middle. Now, that's what you need to see from the Longhorns. He hands it off there to number 34, Justin Sullivan, who really hasn't gotten the ball much today. And he's immediately tackled. Looks like it might have been Costilla or possibly Brian Barber again on the tackle. And Jesus Tafarina was very near the action as well. 3 minutes, 10 seconds to go in the third quarter. Clock really not a factor at this point, but it could be fairly quickly. Second and 13, Lopez hands off to Rogers, who is ankle tackled at the line of scrimmage. Tom Arena this time would not let go of Rogers, and he will pick up about 2 yards, and that may be Rogers who's down right now.
That might be Rogers who's down. That would be a big blow to the Panthers. That's one thing about six-man football, injury. What could an injury do to a three-man football team? Totally wipe it out.
It can devastate it. When you look at one out of your six men who's down, that's the equivalent almost of losing two outstanding players for your 11-man. And the snap goes back to Lopez. Lopez is in trouble. Now he's trying to go to the right side. He avoids one tackle. Now dumps it away. And we're going to have a flag. I believe we're going to have an intentional grounding. I don't see a flag. Back here at the 5 yard line. Indeed, that is the call.
You're right.
National ground. There it is. That's a loss of down, and it will actually, it won't benefit the Longhorns that much, as it would have been fourth down anyway, but it's just going to back the Panthers up a little bit. They would have had to kick the ball away from the 8 yard line. Now they'll have to kick it away from about the 3 yard line. So if you're looking for a defensive stand, Brent, there you have it.
That's it. That's what they need right now. Defense has been Gordon's specialty all year long. You can look at the scores and think they've been blown away offensively, but defense has done the job. That needs to do the job here in the closing minutes.
Justin Straichner is in the back of his end zone to kick this ball away.
It's blocked by Jesus Tafarina. It goes out of the end zone. It's a safety. Oh, big, big play. Unbelievable. Hey, you can't get any better than that defensively. I mean, you really can't. Unless you're gonna catch a, you know, catch a fumble or bring an interception to the touchdown. That's a defensive player's dream to cause a safety like that. And that's what just happened for the Gordon Longhorns for Jesus Tafarina.
Wow. Tafarina was going so quickly to the ball after his block that he didn't want it to go out of the end zone. He wanted to recover it for the touchdown. There's the punt. Pretty good punt on the left side, but Sizemore will get the field at the 13. He's up the right side, now reverses field, now makes the move, and has a nice return up to the 37-yard line. And if you don't think these Longhorn fans are back in their football game, you've got another thing coming.
Did you hear the roar of the crowd when Sizemore fielded that punt? I mean, hey, anytime Sizemore touches the ball, you know you've got a chance. Gordon Longhorn never let him all year long. By the way, he has over 2,000 yards rushing, 2,274 yards on the year. That's without his actions today.
Here we go. First and 15 for Gordon. They have a chance. chance to really turn this thing around. First and 15 from the 37. Hand off side for off the left side. He bounces it outside. He has some room. He's at the 30, the 25, and that's out of bounds at the 20. Wow. That's a 25, 26 yarder for Sizemore. I think you heard him talking about it, Lynn. But I can't sit down any longer. It's just gorgeous crowd to get into this with the players on the sideline. That's the first time I've seen any juice close to their sideline, as they are beginning to think they're back in this ballgame. First and 15 now as Sizemore takes it to the 18-yard line. And Costilla has Tom Arena and Sizemore behind him. Here's a handoff up the middle to Tom Arena. He pulls his way down to the 9-yard line, and we have a flag. We have a flag, and it's going to be some type of penalty against Windhill as Tom Arena goes down, and they threw the flag on top of Tom Arena. Let's see if it's a face mask or a late hit, but it's going to be one of the two. It's a face mask. I tell you what, Tom Arena looks like John Levin right there, the way he pounded through that line. Let's see, how much does Tom Arena weigh? 145 pounds, 265 pounds, maybe.
And 100 difference. 145 is a big stretch for Jesus Tom Arena.
Yeah, that's right.
He is the smallest guy out on that football field, but he ran with the most power and authority of anyone out there just then.
First and goal to go. Actually, it's second and about two from the 5-yard line, so they could get a first down. Costilla hands off to Sizemore off the right side. He's hit behind the line of scrimmage, but somehow stays on his feet and gets back into the original line of scrimmage, maybe even picked up a half a yard. As I would venture to say that Sizemore is running with a bit more confidence than he did in the first half of this ball game. It's going to be very close to a first down. He picked up a yard. It looks like he's going to be short, but they're going to bring in the sticks and measure. And that could be important, as it would be otherwise. Third down, and less than one, or first and goal to go.
I'll tell you what,
if Gordon scores right here, you can look back at that safety. You can keep looking back at that safety all the way through and hit the ball. If he can Gordon in this football game, I think that safety, I don't care if it's 2 points. That's the biggest play in the ball game so far.
No doubt about it. So it's third and about a foot from the 4-yard line, and look for Jason Sizemore to get this football.
No, it's a handoff inside to Tom Arena. He stopped at about the 2. He should have the first down. He should have. He stretched out a nice second effort there. He gets a yard, but it's a big, big yard in the football game.
There's the indication, first down. Longhorns will have 4 opportunities to poke it in from the 2-yard line. And you'd have to believe the momentum has changed here. A minute, 12 seconds to go in the third quarter. And what looked as if a dire situation only moments ago has turned into a pretty positive one for Gordon. There's a handoff to Sizemore. He's hitting the backfield, and he'll lose a couple of yards. That almost looked like a broken play, as Levin and Sizemore both were near Costilla when he tried to hand the ball off to Sizemore, and that one just never developed. And that would probably anger Coach Nelson Campbell. I don't know who was on. But somebody went the wrong direction in the backfield. Number 33, Jeremy Jackson, coming off the field. Joe Costilla goes in now to replace him. Levin, Tom Arena, and Sizemore in the backfield as we have second and goal from the 4. Costilla rolling around, wants to throw the ball. Now he's in trouble. He better do something. He's at the 10. He rifles it to Sizemore. He got down to the corner of the end zone. Oh! A 4-yard touchdown reception for Jason Sizemore. And I tell you what, Sizemore stood there in the corner. The guy who made that play, no doubt about it, the quarterback, Jim Costilla. He stood around in the back waiting for something to happen. And all of a sudden, he was in big trouble. He had to run around in several semi-circles to get out of trouble. He finally threw the pass in the corner. He ended up, great job for the Gordon Longhorns. That was all Jim Costilla, and we've seen his tremendous athletic ability before, and the kick is blocked, and that is going to be important. We have a ball game here. The Gordon Longhorns have emerged. They are back from the dead. There's the kickoff. It goes down the windmill. It's touched at the 5-yard line, and now he tries to work himself out of trouble and he won't. Matt Backers touched the football about the 5-yard line, lost it,